This is a story about a red Indian boy called Little Chief Paddlefoot. You could pretend to be Little Chief Paddlefoot while I tell the story. Early one sunny morning, Little Chief Paddlefoot was sitting cross-legged in front of his wigwam. That's what a red Indian calls his tent. And while Little Chief Paddlefoot was sitting there, he suddenly felt very hungry. "Wow," he said to himself, rubbing his tummy. "I haven't had any breakfast. I'm hungry." So he picked up his bow and arrow and went off into the forest to hunt for breakfast. Little Chief Paddlefoot crept along as quiet as can be in his soft leather moccasin shoes. Hid behind a tree. Then very carefully he peeped out and looked this way and that way. No, no one about. So on he crept as quiet as can be in his soft leather moccasin shoes. He hadn't gone very far when he came to a stream. In the stream there was a fish. Now, Little Chief Paddlefoot liked eating fish for breakfast. And Little Chief Paddlefoot was very hungry. So he tried to catch that little fish. But it was much too slithery. And with a flick of its tail and a can't catch me, it swam away quick as a wink. Little Chief Paddlefoot felt hungrier than ever. So on he crept, quiet as can be, in his soft leather moccasin shoes. He hadn't gone very much further when he stopped again. Shh! What was that? He hid behind a tree. Then he peeped out and looked this way and that way. It was a rabbit. A rabbit running away down the path with its little white tail going bobbity jump, bobbity jump. Little Chief Paddlefoot felt hungrier and hungrier. He still hadn't found anything for breakfast. So on he crept as quiet as can be in his soft leather moccasin shoes. He'd gone a long, long way by now, when all of a sudden he stopped again. Shh! What was that? He hid behind a tree. Then he peeped out And looked this way. And that way. It was a bird. A bird singing way up on top of the tallest tree. Little Chief Paddlefoot was tired by now. Down he sat at the foot of the tree, shut his eyes, and listened to the bird. Oh, that bird had flown away. Little Chief Paddlefoot sat there at the bottom of the tree, all by himself. He was very, very tired, and he was much, much hungrier than he'd been before. Then, shh, what was that? Was it somebody calling him? It was his mother, and she was calling him to come home for breakfast. Little Chief Paddlefoot forgot all about his hunting. He forgot all about creeping quietly through the forest. He jumped up and ran down the path as quickly as he could. And as he ran, he called,
"Hi-ho, hum, hi-ho, hum, I am coming, here I come. Ooh, ooh, hi-ho, hum, hi-ho, hum, I am coming, here I come. Ooh."
And he ran and he ran and he ran, till he'd run all the way home to his own wigwam. And there was his mother, and there was his father, Big Chief Paddlefoot, and there was his brother, Eagle Feather, and his sister, Laughing Face, and there was his breakfast, already waiting for him. So Little Chief Paddlefoot forgot about his hunting, forgot about his bow and arrow, forgot about the fish, forgot about the rabbit, and forgot about the bird. And Little Chief Paddlefoot sat down, cross-legged in front of his wigwam, and he ate his breakfast all up, every bit of it. And then he wasn't hungry anymore.
I'm a great big Indian chief.